فلا سبيل إلى أن يكون المسلم من الفرقة الناجية إلا بأن يتبع الكتاب والسنة وعلى ما كان عليه السلف الصالح.
Similarly, ikhwan, from the ahadith that we have established in regards to the tarheeb of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the messenger instilling fear, ikhwan, in the heart of his family, nurturing them and cultivating them upon that which is correct, nurturing them and cultivating them upon a love for that which pleases Allah and a hatred for that which displeases Allah. The hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, who mentioned that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on an occasion returned from a journey and entered upon me, and I had made in a corner or in a part of the room some curtains that had upon them tamathil, that had images upon them, that had upon them images, يعني images of living يعني beings. So she mentioned, فلما رآها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتكه. So she mentioned that indeed, لما رآه, when the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم saw it, that he ripped it down and tore it. When he saw that, he ripped it down and tore it. وقال أشد الناس عذابا يوم القيامة الذين يضاهون بخلق الله. He mentioned that he said that the worst of the people being punished on the day of judgment are those who compete with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني Aisha radiallahu anha, the narration does not inform us, ikhwan, of the fact that Aisha radiallahu anha drew those images on that curtain, except that the curtain had upon it images. The messenger removed it, ripped that, and then mentioned to her that which will instill fear in her heart, that the worst of the people that will be punished on the day of judgment are those who compete with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then she mentioned that she took that material and turned the images inside out and turned them into cushions. So that, ikhwan, is another example of how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instilled fear in the heart of his wives and of his family, instilling in them the hatred for that which displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another example, ikhwan, of that is that which we have, ikhwan, collected by Ibn Hibban, who mentioned, ikhwan, that on occasion during the time of the fitna between the companions, that which took place, ikhwan, from the dispute between Ali and the dispute between Muawiyah radiallahu anhuma, that Aisha radiallahu anha left out, ikhwan, in order to try and remove the dispute or remove the fitna and remove the anger or remove that which had taken place from the dispute between both parties. And in order to rectify and bring about rectification between both sides, so she set out on an occasion. And that was narrated to us, and we are informed concerning that in the narration that occurs in Ibn Hibban, wherein Qais mentioned that Aisha radiallahu anha journeyed until they reached the waters of Bani Amir during the night. And at that time, she heard the barking of dogs. When they reached the waters of Banu Amir, some waters that were known as the waters of Al-Hawab, that they reached those waters and she heard the barking of dogs. So upon hearing that, she mentioned and she asked the question, أيما إن هذه. She mentioned, أيما إن هذا. Which waters are these? What waters are these? And it was said to her, ماء الهوأب. It was said, they are the waters of الهوأب. So upon hearing that, She said, "Ma adhunnuni illa anni raji'atun." So she said, "I do not see myself except returning." After questioning, what waters were these? And it was established that they were the waters of Al-Hawab. She said, "Indeed, I do not see myself except returning. I'm going back." So those who were with her, who had set out alongside her, in order to bring about rectification between the Muslims, they said, and they turned to her, and said, "Rather you should continue, so that the Muslimin should see you, and يصلح الله عز وجل ذات بينهم," and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should bring about rectification between them. So look, ikhwan, in that is no doubt a refutation against those who say that they disputed or who reviled the Sahaba concerning ikhwan, the fact that their dispute was out of evil or on the basis of some evil or some love for power and status, or other than that from the statements that are made concerning the companions. Rather, we see here it is established that their intent, ikhwan, was nothing other than to make islah and to rectify between the Muslims. So they said, "No, you should continue, so that they should see you, yani mother of the believers, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should rectify between the Muslims by way of you." So then she went on to say, قالت إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لها ذات يوم. And as occurs in some riwayat, that there were a group of the wives of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam present when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them on an occasion, كيف بإحدى كنا تنبه عليها كلاب الهوأب, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "How will it be for one of you? How will it be for one of you who the dogs of Al-Hawab